Hello friends, if you are looking for an answer to this question, what is agile testing? Then please, come on, let's go and figure out the answer to this in my today's presentation. Welcome to my channel Q Analysis, and please don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. If you want to learn more about QA and software testing techniques, latest news and job related tips, please feel free to subscribe my channel and blog. In today's presentation, we are going to talk about these points which I have mentioned over here in the overview: traditional versus agile testing, traditional versus agile approach, agile testing manifesto, how to perform agile testing, golden rules of agile testing, role of a tester in agile, and what is agile testing. Check your agile testing status. Moving on to our first topic, that is traditional versus agile. So in traditional approach, you might have seen most of us in past used to follow the traditional approach, wherein one stage of software development will take place only when the previous step or the initial step has completed, then only the step next to it used to start. For example, project estimation, requirement gathering, once it is done, then only the use cases or functional specs will be prepared. Once the use cases or functional specs have been prepared, then only design will take place. And once you have all the design in place, then coding will happen. And if all coding is done, then only the testing is performed. And finally, once all testing has been done, then the whole modules are integrated and integration or regression is being performed, and finally it is released to the production. So this used to be the traditional approach, which has changed now. And when we talk about agile, all these things, they take place but in a very short span of time and in a time box manner, which is known as sprints. Here we have something like inception, after inception, everything, requirement gathering, use cases preparation, design specification, coding, testing and integration, it takes place in iterations. And instead of waiting till last, we keep on doing all this activity from the beginning itself, and we do it in a fashion that we have a shippable product at the end of every sprint, and we keep on doing it on a regular basis. So you can see the clear difference here: one module, second module, third module, fourth module, fifth, sixth, like this module approach, waterfall. Over here, all these modules, they take place in single sprint. You can say it like this, and once we have something which is shippable already, then we move on to the next sprint and we keep on doing it. And this is the way agile testing or agile approach is performed. Agile testing manifesto. Agile testing manifesto, I'll list down, it has a number of points, but I'll list down the main 5 points, which as per me are the most important ones. First, collaborative ownership over detached objectivity. So unlike previously, where QA or testers used to be a detached team who is responsible for testing, over here in agile testing, it's a collaborative ownership. Quality is a collaborative ownership. It's a team's responsibility. Over here, defect prevention is more important than defect detection. Instead of developing the whole application or whole software and then finding out defect, first of all, test cases are prepared, and then using TDD or BDD, development is done in a way so that defect is minimized by pairing with the programmer, pairing with the developers, and testers pairing with developers and programmers. And test cases are made first, and initially there is no code, so test cases are failing. Later on, code is developed and they should pass the test case. In this way, defect prevention approach is taken or adopted. Targeted automation over the widespread regression. Instead of in the previous approach, there used to be widespread regression, everything used to be regressed, regression testing was performed, whereas now in agile testing, targeted automation of the specific regression area is the main one of the main manifesto items. Exploratory testing over predetermined scripting. Instead of writing up the test cases and going and executing those test cases one by one in a very structured and scripted manner, what we used to do in in the primitive or the waterfall or traditional life cycle model. Here we do exploratory testing. If you want to know more about exploratory testing, please feel free to watch my another presentation. You can find the link in the description, which talks about exploratory testing techniques. So exploratory testing technique is done in a time box charter manner, and there's no definite set of planning, no scripting. Depending upon the experience of the tester, they go ahead and try to break the system as soon as they can and find as many as defects as possible in minimum and maximum execution in minimum amount of time. And the last but not the least, value addition over persistent criticism. Testers are many a time being considered as the criticizers, like they criticize developers, they criticize designers, but no, the things have changed in agile methodology. Over here, testers or quality professionals are taken as the value addition, since everybody right away, from the developers, from business analysts, from designers, even the business stakeholders, everybody is responsible for the quality. So quality and quality professionals are considered to provide value and add value to their whole quality system. How to perform agile testing? Now over here in this diagram, I'll tell you what exactly is agile life cycle and where is testing fitting into all this. So as soon as we have the requirement, after the inception to the start of project, requirements are defined, high level requirements, at least you have a high level requirement for user stories. Development team, they start working on it. You have designers who are developing designs. Everything starts to work. As soon as you have user story with the acceptance criteria defined, developers, they design it, they develop it, testers, they test it. If any defect is being found, then and there it is resolved. And using continuous integration, builds are prepared on day-to-day basis. Again and again, with every commit, build is being pushed. So you do integrate and test again and again with every code commit, and it keeps on going. So these are different development life cycles, development cycles going on, and iterations going on, and testing going on. Once you are done with the testing, when I say testing, it involves unit testing, it involves integration testing, it involves automation testing, regression using automation testing, plus it involves exploratory testing by the tester itself. Then the release, final release scope is determined, and all the items they are taken into consideration. There's a feedback review process wherein everybody right away, from developers, users, clients and testers, they provide the feedback. If everybody is happy with the quality, it is accepted, and then it is released to the market, to the end users. After testing, that is user acceptance testing, it is released to the market. If at all there is any issue or something which is stopping or any quality related problem, in that case there is a no, and then the issues are recorded and changes which are to be incorporated, that are recorded, and then it is adjusted. Tracking, defect tracking, requirement tracking has been taken care of, and next iteration is performed, and the whole cycle is repeated till the time you receive a shippable product which is highly very high in quality and ready to be shipped to the end users. And this is what on high level happens as a part of agile testing. Moving on to the next slide, which talks about the golden rules of agile testing. The golden rule of agile testing is three. These are the three golden rules. First, testing is not a phase. We are not doing testing as a phase or at the end or at the starting. Testing is being done, or quality is being done, at each and every phase, at each and every step and every process of agile process. Agile team tests continuously, and continuous testing is the only way to ensure continuous quality delivery. Okay friends, the next golden rule is testing moves the project forward. Right away, from the time you initiate a project and you get the requirement, then and there acceptance criteria is being defined, test cases, test scenario, high level scenarios are being defined, and then agile testing provides feedback on an ongoing basis, and the product meets the business demand, and as soon as the product is meeting the requirement and is passing all the cases, it becomes more and more viable and high quality for the users. So testing moves the project forward. And last but not the least, everyone tests. Testing is not just one person's responsibility or only quality professional, quality analyst or tester's responsibility. Each and every member in Agile team is responsible for quality and is not just testing team's responsibility. Now, role of a tester in Agile. Let's talk about this in our next slide. You can see I have written QA, quality analyst with the business analyst, QA with UX user experts, QA with developers, QA with the stakeholders, and QA with DevOps. So, as I mentioned earlier, quality is a very important part of each and every step that is taken, that we do or perform as a part of Agile methodology. Quality analysts, they work hand in hand with business analysts and they help in defining the requirement, deciding the acceptance criteria, and creating different kind of business scenarios, use cases. Quality analysts, they work with the UX team and design teams and they figure out what are the different kind of, whether the design which is being developed by the UX team is going to meet the requirement. If at all there is any deviation, they report the issues and bugs. Development team, but obvious, we always testers, they always work in parallel, and with agile methodology coming into picture, we have parallel programming, test-driven development, business-driven development, where testers and developers, they work hand in hand. And then you have key QA and stakeholders, all the end users, business users, user acceptance testing, or whenever we have a shippable product which is to be delivered to the users, they need to have a kind of testing mechanism with the testers and the users. And the last, QA and DevOps, continuous integration, continuous delivery is a very important part of Agile methodology. So QA and DevOps, they go hand in hand. So what is Agile testing? Agile testing, as per me, involves all members of a cross-functional team with a special expertise contributed by testers to ensure the delivery of business value desired by customers at continuous intervals by applying Agile principles. Agile testing focuses on continuous checks, feedbacks, so as to fix issues immediately rather than waiting for the end of the project. And last, testing and development are done incrementally and interactively, building up each feature until it provides enough value to release it to the production. Now, these are the three points which define Agile testing as per me. Agile testing ensures that we are testing in a continuous fashion, in an iterative and incremental pattern or incremental way, and then we are fixing issues immediately rather than waiting for the end, and we are providing value. There is a value addition to our business, to customer's business, and a shippable product is received in a very frequent manner, in a continuous manner. This is what is Agile testing as per me. Now, if you see that you have moved from waterfall to Agile, or you are practicing Agile testing, how will you ensure that your Agile testing is working fine, or you are up to the mark, or whether it is working in a good way, or whether you need some kind of improvement? So anything, I'm a tester, I don't believe in something which is just theoretical. I need to measure it, I need to validate it. So in order to validate your Agile testing success, I have few points for you. First is there any increase in the rate and the quality of feedback? So if you can see there's an increase in the rate at which you are getting feedback and the quality of feedback what you are getting has increased, then yes, your Agile is going in a good way. If not, then it's the other way around. Is there a waste reduction? When I say waste reduction, man, material, process related waste, is there any waste reduction? There should be ideally a waste reduction because of successful agile implementation and successful agile testing implementation. Is there a reduction in integration time and increase in the integration rate? So once you implement the agile testing techniques, then as a result of continuous integration, the integration time should reduce, it should fall down, and your integration rate should increase. Is testing phased or independent? Now this is very important. Your testing should not be phased anymore. It used to be phased and it used to happen at the last or once your development is complete. But now, if you are implementing agile testing techniques, then testing is no more phased. It is independent and it is conducted at each and every step of your development and your testing schedule, software development lifecycle. This is conducted at everywhere. Is testing start at the testing starting at the business at the beginning or towards the end? Now, as I mentioned in the previous point, testing should happen everywhere and it should start at the beginning itself. Is there an increase in the delivery? The continuous delivery, your delivery, has it increased? Has it become more frequent? If yes, then your agile testing is moving in the right direction and you are succeeding. If not, then you have to figure out issues and you need to figure out where is the bottleneck and you have to improve on it. Okay, friends. Thanks a lot. This was my presentation on agile testing. Please feel free to share your feedback. And if you like my video, don't hesitate to like, share, and subscribe my channel. I look forward to your support. Thanks a lot, friends. Thank you.